It's permissible to you when there's no women around. That's what my daddy said.
That's why Jesus called your dog.
Then
stop trying to
debate. No. Get me the hadith from Sahih Bukhari.
So is this true? I'm about to read.
It's hot.
Go back to the field, man, bring your evidence.
The Bible says that. It says to Moses, kill a woman and little children. Little girls. Why you left the little girls for?
You're committing sin to this man.
Look.
See what lie you said.
It's not that speak.
Did you say that?
Christian man believes marriage only sex. Is the marriage only sex? My question, is marriage only sex?
You're embarrassing yourself.
Because Christianity is marriage only sex.
Well, lies, waste of time. Is marriage only sex? Is marriage only sex? Is marriage only sex? A woman is a sex toy to you. Christian woman. No, woman, we respect her. We love her. We take care of her. To the Christians, she's a sex toy. To the Christian woman, she's a sex toy. Not every Christian person, yeah? This one specific. You don't have to be dressed. Because I'm Christian, I don't say that.
So the,
she loves to be sex toy.
No, can you
stay away from me, please?
With your hair.
Okay, so good luck. Allah save us. Anyway, because you God breastfed. You God was touching woman breasts. You God was touching woman breasts.
Go.
You said Prophet Muhammad, kaddab, liar, evil. You're evil, innocent. You just said Prophet Muhammad, putrefied, liar. Look at you with the evil face.
Your God is a pedophile.
Where did I say Muhammad's a pedophile?
Yes.
Wait.
Get in my direction, man.
Is there a
problem with it?
It's filthy, disgusting. Yeah, anyway,
I said yes. Look, this is a donkey guy.
Listen, I didn't say
can
filthy,
speak to him,
I said Muhammad is disgusting.
In the Bible, God who's touching woman's breasts, is that disgusting or not?
Keep the little ones for us.
Is it that disgusting?
What your God was doing in a little girl's vagina? What your God was doing in a little girl's vagina?
Sunan Abu Dawud.
Yes, no Bukhari. Who's the Bukhari?
Abu Dawud.
You don't listen.
Okay, go.
No, you don't listen.
Okay, when you read it, bear in mind, he says, okay, to kill babies.
Hadith 162.
Go on.
Okay, so narrated Salama ibn al-Aqwa. The messenger of Allah appointed Abu Bakr our commander. And we fought with some people who were polytheists. And we attacked them at night.
Attacked them at night.
Killing them. Yes? So we attacked them at night, killing them.
Yes.
Our war cry that night was put to death, put to death. Salama said, I killed that night with my hand, polytheists, to seven houses.
Wait. So why are you reading this one?
Hold on.
Why is reading this?
Forget it, man.
This guy is a clown.
Anyway. This is it, yeah.
Anyway.
So Subhan Ibn Majah, the chapters on jihad.
Ibn Majah, not everything is sahih.
So you pick and choose.
You're going to argue, we're going to speak.
Prove to me that hadith is accurate.
Okay, wait.
Prove to me that
hadith is accurate. Now I'm speaking. Now, if I'm going to make a claim, I have to back it up. Not ask the person to back it up for me. You making the claim, you need to back it up. So my question to the Christians here, is it okay to slaughter a baby's alive intentionally?
If God says so, yes.
If God says yes, so if God says the Prophet Muhammad to marry Aisha, what is the problem with you?
He didn't.
Ah, you see? So you have no problem. So your problem is not he got married to Aisha. Your problem, Prophet Muhammad was no prophet. That's the problem. So about Aisha, about fighting, they have no problem with that. Why? Because in the Bible says, burn your daughter alive. Wait. Would you burn your daughter alive?
It's Sahih.
Wait.
It's Sahih.
No, I didn't say that.
No, but is this Sahih? You said that it was offensive.
I said, what's it to you? Ibn Majah, not every narration there is Sahih.
It's Sahih.
But there's another narration in Bukhari.
Is this narration Sahih?
No, I don't know about this one.
No, but that's what we're showing you. It's Sahih.
Next time, just bring the book, man.
Look, read it.
Yeah, Darussalam. I don't know about Darussalam.
No,
just bring the book next time.
By who?
This is it.
What's his name? Read it.
What?
Read who says Sahih? Wait. Who's Darussalam?
You just
No,
you.
Hey, listen, allow it.
Chelsea, you. No, you are much better than him. But come on, man.
Chelsea, you're wasting your time, man. Allow it, man.
Darussalam is not. It's a bookstore.
Okay.
Okay.
Black wheels.
So, are you saying?
No, I didn't say that. I said the hadith. I know. Let me
just.
The hadith. Wait. My point here was, yeah. They tried to compare when God said in the Bible to slaughter the babies alive with the hadith in Sahih Bukhari. Sahih Bukhari, what happened? I was explaining to him. The Messenger of Allah sent an army to fight against his enemies, yes? So what happened when he attacked them by night? In the morning they found out there were children and women among them. So they went to the compare the Prophet Muhammad, said, oh Prophet Muhammad. So what you have to understand, Prophet Muhammad never ordered it. He never said go and kill them. The companions, they never knew about it. So they went back. So don't ever try to compare. No, you missed it before.
Because you tried to say this is
not offensive. Madi said that what I was saying to you.
Okay, he's offensive. Let's read it.
No, let me finish. No, let me finish.
Why are we arguing?
No, this one, I don't know. I don't know about this one. I don't know about this one, I'm saying.
You don't know.
I don't know.
Okay, let's read it.
No, you can't read it if you don't know. You're not offensive, no. We have to be offensive before you read.
How
you have to check it.
Okay, you give us your criteria.
This is not the Bible.
Okay, wait.
You give us your criteria.
Wait, is it good? Let me share this benefit. How do we know authentic hadith? ما رواه العدل الضابط عن مثله إلى منتهى بغير علة ولا شذوذ. A chain of narrators that all of them are trustworthy, honest, with a strong memory, and all of them met each other without going and guess what is one known. So if a narration go and guess what is no one known, then you become shudud, okay? And illa without a hidden deficient. That's for the hadith to be authentic. So therefore, you don't know the name of the narrators,
give
all of them.
Give us all the narrators for...
You are bringing it on me.
No, you're saying...
Oh, this is a joke.
This is on you.
This is your criteria. That's a joke.
This is your criteria.
This is a joke. So you say... That's not my criteria, Godwin. That's not my criteria.
I'm responding to
you. No, but it's not my criteria. It's the criteria of Al-Islam.
No, I'm responding to what you said. You said
that you're wasting your time.
Muslims, is it okay to slaughter babies alive?
No!
Is it okay to slaughter babies alive?
Yes.
Is it okay? He's taking him time to say no. I want people to put in their title Arab Abu Bakr al-Baghdadi and his crew in speaker's corner.
Okay, so...
Look at his face, He looks unhappy.
Mohammed said, I've been made victorious with terror. Explain that.
No, that's a good one. That's a good one. He said that...
Black dog.
But far right would say that.
He said a good question.
Yeah.
Look, you see, if you ask, I will answer, no problem.
Listen.
He said, Prophet Muhammad, can you ask us to stop hacking? She's hacking. Okay. She's talking to me.
Didn't your mother tell you?
Here we go.
My mother, she never meets with too many men.
She didn't.
Okay, alhamdulillah. Anyway, my point here is, and you know I respect you. You know, in the conversation. Yeah, but you try to say something
about
Prophet
Muhammad.
Yeah, but that's what you said. I was asking, I was asking him, he believed marriage is sex, and you agreed with him.
No, I said you've got more chance of having sex within a marriage.
No, but Amma, that's not my question. Why are you buttering in if you don't know what I was saying?
I wasn't answering.
Okay, sorry for misunderstanding. No, sorry. You see, as a Muslim, I'm a respectful person, alhamdulillah. If I'm wrong, I would say sorry. Without any love. That's my teacher, my Prophet Muhammad, who said, do not kill children and women, السلام, by the way. Okay? So now, Prophet Muhammad said, from the miracles that Allah has given him, if he's going to wage war against his enemies, then Allah will cause a fear in their heart. So what's the problem with that?
Where's that from so I can read?
Sahih Bukhari, it's hadith.
Give me the name so I can.
The name is Abu Abdullah Muhammad bin Ismail Bukhari.
Reference. Sahih Bukhari, what book?
Hadith Jabir. The narrator is Jabir ibn Abdullah.
So Sahih Bukhari.
Jabir ibn Abdullah. I don't know. I'm not a computer. Google here. My name is Shamsi, by the way. No, but you can check it anyway. But the point here is, no, tell me, would you burn your daughter alive? Excuse me.
So,
would your boy burn a daughter alive?
What's Akida?
What happened to your beard sending green?
What's Akida?
You sending green?
Where's your beard?
None.
Where's your beard?
You have none.
Where's your beard?
Ask Abita.
No,
I have more than you.
Why is your beard not growing?
Allah created me this way.
You're polypish. That was your word and your polypish.
Oh, come on. That's bad arguments.
Let's know. You're meant to be the imam.
Anyway, brothers and sisters, what you see that we the Christians, they try to justify burning your daughter alive. In the Bible, says if your daughter she's a prostitute, you should burn her alive. Excuse me, would you burn your daughter alive?
No, we don't. I won't.
So you don't follow Bible? He doesn't follow God. So you don't follow God?
Will you kill a Muslim who's pious?
No. Wait.
Will you honor the designation of a Muslim?
Wait. I will not kill him, no.
I'm not asking you.
You have asked me.
I said no.
So you was wrong, we said
so
to do it.
Okay, so ask my question.
So you're not Christian. He just became kafir. He became disbeliever in the Bible. Alhamdulillah. Soon become Muslim. We have one here. Put him aside.
If your prophet or
would you ban it to life?
My question.
All Christians, answer my question, please. Would you ban your daughter alive?
No. Your prophet ordered the assassination of a Muslim because he was being too pious.
Because the Bible says that. You're not a Christian. Akhwa, you know Christians, you should wear niqab. You should wear niqab, you too. Your Bible full of banned daughters alive. And if your wife, watch, imagine you're fighting and your wife helps you in fight. You know what is the reward? Cut her off her hands. Imagine instead of saying, thank you, my wife, for helping me. They're following the Bible, by the way.
He agrees.
He agrees. He's for the Old Testament. He agrees.
That's our answer.
Alhamdulillah. Would you ban your daughter alive?
Would you ban your daughter alive? Allow for innocent child to be killed?
Okay, go.
Did he allow that? Yes or no? Did Allah allow for innocent child to be killed?
He was not child.
He was not child.
He was not child. Ghulam mean he was a young boy.
So he was a young boy?
Yes, young boy.
So,
you know why? No, do you know why? No. Wait.
So what is the child?
Wait.
He said,
My question. He has an answer. Would you ban your daughter alive? Muslims, would you ban your daughter alive?
Why are you ISIS?
Would you ban your daughter alive? Are you ISIS follower?
Let him speak and then you respond.
Are you ISIS? Don't you think you're going on?
He was reading from the Quran.
I'm not going to let him read until you answer my questions. Answer my questions. Is it okay to ban your daughter alive?
So they set off after leaving the show. Look at you. So they set off after leaving the ship.
They love Jalalay. Jalalay cannot handle this.
When they met a
boy. That's not Quran.
When they do not yet reach puberty.
The verse doesn't say that. That's the verse. He doesn't know tafsir on the verse.
It doesn't matter what the Quran is. I don't blind follow scholars.
So you know more than the scholar. No, wait.
You know more than Angela.
I'll tell you what. I don't blind follow him.
No, he's not infallible.
That's it.
Let's read this. Okay.
Good. Why are you reading this not first? If the Bible says kill babies and children,
playing with other boys,
are you going to kill babies?
Among whom his
face. When he said kill babies alive, that's a Bible reading, by the way.
And Al Qadir slew him by slitting his throat with a knife while he lay down, or by tearing his head against a wall.
I gave you proof. You saw the Bible.
Opinions of the coordination. Allah allowed for this to happen. Yes or no?
Can I speak now?
Yes or no?
Can I speak?
Yes or no?
In order to say yes or no, I have to speak.
Go on.
Yes or no.
Thank you.
No, only say yes.
Allah, that's all we need to know.
Take it. Kill babies alive. When I said the young boy Allah sent the Quran, he was going to grow up as an evil girl. But in the Bible,
Quick rapper.
So every week Shamsi comes along and he pulls out all these random Old Testament verses about God, you know, allowing for innocent children to kill. But clearly in the Quran, when you read it, it clearly states that Allah allowed for innocent child to be killed. And when we read it, he said his head smashed. It was a brutal, ugly death that this child received. It was an innocent child which Allah allowed to happen. And so it makes no sense for Shamsi then to go around and start saying, well, hold on, look at what the God of the Old Testament did. See, God, in our scripture, we know that God creates life and also has the right to take life away. But what Muslims would say that if it's an innocent child, God doesn't have the right. But in the Quran, it states that clearly, and it's backed by the scholars, clearly that Allah allowed for innocent child to be killed. Why? Because they thought that sometime in the future, this child would commit some type of sin, which doesn't make any logical sense. I would encourage my Muslim friends to turn away from that false God of the Quran and come to the truth, God of the Bible. God bless you.